invited me to be part of their StoryFest at home. I've been writing for about 20 years now, and in that time I've written lots of books, most of them for children. So a few I happen to randomly have on my lap here. There's the Alice series, my first children's books, which always kind of close to my heart. Then I went on to the Eva series, which there's five or six books, I think, in that series. And then I wrote some books about Molly and Beth. Two of them I have here, Time After Time and You've Got a Friend. There's another one in that series too. And last year, I wasn't quite sure what I was going to write next, and it was suggested to me that maybe I would write some historical fiction. And at first I resisted that idea because I thought that's not really what I'd like to do. But I got over myself and I began to do a bit of research, and I decided I would like to write a book set in Lissadell House around the beginning of the last century. Now, in Lissadell House at the time, there were lots of famous people. Countess Markievicz was from the family who owned that house, and her sister Eva Gore Booth, and other people that would be quite well known would have been in that house at the time. But I didn't particularly want to tell their stories. I wanted to include those people, but I didn't want to have it all about them. So I came up with a girl called Lily, and she was going to be a housemaid in that house. And I chose her to tell her story because my grandparents had both worked in big houses when they were very young. And Lily had to leave school when she was a very young girl because her family needed her to bring home money. And she was sad about that, and she wasn't given any choice of career. She was told she had to go and work as a housemaid. So I had great fun researching that book and telling Lily's story. And it came out last year, and it was called Lily at Lissadell. And in fact, I enjoyed it so much that at the moment I'm working on the sequel to that, which will be out, if I actually get my act together and finish it, will be out later on this year. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read one or two pages from Lily at Lissadell, and then I'll leave you all in peace. So in this section of the book, Lily has been staying in Lissadell House because it's too far for her to go home every day. And this is her first visit home after a week at Lissadell. And she's missed her family while she was there, so she's very excited to be back. Later, Mam and I made dinner together. And though the food was plain and simple, I enjoyed the meal more than any I'd had in my week at Lissadell. After dinner, Mam said she had loads of darning to do, so she sat down and began to work. I knew she was only making an excuse so we could have some quiet time together, but I didn't tell her that. Winnie climbed onto my lap, put her thumb in her mouth, and used her other hand to play with my curls. Within seconds, she was asleep. I wanted that moment to last forever and ever, with my little sister warm in my arms and my lovely Mam sitting across from me, listening as if my stories were the best stories she'd ever heard in her whole life. "And how are things in the big house, Lily?" asked Mam. "Are you doing everything they tell you? You're not being skittish. Is the work hard? Are they good to you?" So I told her all about my new life. I know Mam missed my company when I was gone, so I made it all sound funny. Even the endless sweeping and dusting, and the blackleading of the grates that left my fingers stained and sore. I didn't tell her that for much of the time I was afraid of doing or saying something wrong. I didn't tell her that for much of the time I was lonely and almost ready to cry. "And have you made any friends?" she asked. "There's Nelly," I said. "Is she your friend?" "I wouldn't say that. We sleep in the same room and we work together every day, but I don't think she's my friend." "Why not?" "I'm not sure. Mostly she's grumpy and barely talks to me, so I decide I hate her. Then she surprises me and gets all chatty, and I decide I like her again. And then she's mean and, oh, I don't know, Mam, it's hard when I can't decide if she's nice or not." Mam put down her needle and patted my hand. "Oh dear, that does sound a bit confusing. But you know what they say, you shouldn't judge someone until you've walked a mile in their shoes." "I'd never walk a mile or even one single step in Nelly's shoes. She'd murder me if she saw me touching anything of hers." Mam laughed. "You know exactly what I mean. Just give her a chance, and who knows? Maybe one day this Nelly girl will be your very best friend." And if you want to know if that happens, you're going to have to read the book. So I apologise if this sounds a little bit stilted, because I'm not really used to talking to machines. I think I'm better at talking to people. So it's not personal if this sounds a little bit false. And I'd like to thank my production team, who are my daughters, who are working from home and who may or may not still be in their pyjamas at this late stage of the day. Thanks very much.